So I'll leave you with Mrs. Simmons here.
Warning, it's about to get a little bit loud. Hi. Oh, sorry. Hello, my name is Ms. Simmons, and I wish I could say that we totally planned to bring two of your former alumni here. I think it's Michael Shannon and Raquel Shannon. Stand up, Sir Michael, so they know who you are. They graduated from this lovely institution, and I did not realize that till I got here and I saw your wall of fame. Who is going to be joining that wall of fame this year? Put your hands up. Be proud of that. That's amazing. You're joining the Wall of Fame already? Wow, my goodness. Honey, they get younger and younger every single year. Well, you're joining the Wall of Fame? Okay, listen, I've not been on a Wall of Fame myself as a homeschooler, so you got one on me, okay? But this is our jazz ensemble from Campion Academy. This is a brand new ensemble. They're so spanking new that some of them haven't even played their instrument for very, very long. We have got Kiana Davis here. She just started learning tenor saxophone. We have Sarah Molina, who just started learning the trumpet. We have Mr. Caleb, who just transitioned to the trombone. We've got Miss over here, Miss Effie Lang, who is just learning the saxophone this year. So we are a brand spanking new ensemble, and it's just really fun for us to get out and play a few pieces. And jazz doesn't play too many sacred sets, so we know you're Sir Chapel. We're going to make sure we put a few of those in there, but not with this ensemble. Their next section is going to get a little faster. I said the first one was loud. This next one is fast. And we're going to get even faster with the third one, and you're going to help us with that in a second. I'll tell you how that's going to work. So our next piece is going to be Charlie. Here we go. One, two, one, two, three, four. Thank you. Now, in the spirit of highlighting more people, I want to highlight Mr. Sturgis back there. Apparently, and I did not know this again, give him a round of applause. Mr. Sturgis is making us sound really nice in here, so thank you so much, sir. He has a son who goes to a Campion Academy named Preston. I didn't realize, so I saw the man face to face, and I realized that's Preston in the flesh, just older. So it's fantastic that we have such good connections with your school here. We love being here. You've been so welcoming and wonderful. I saw a few of you, I believe, at a music festival just a little while ago. Didn't I? Was any of you here? Yes, I knew your faces looked very familiar. Okay, so I did meet you guys before, and I met your sponsors as well. You were fantastic then, and you're still fantastic now. Thank you so much. I want to highlight something. How many of you are doing music here? I saw some fantastic handbells back there on the table. There's a few of you, quite a few of you. Okay, fantastic. Do you know when I say the word tempo, what that means? Uh-oh. Is the music teacher here? Yes, somebody knows. Blue shirt. Yes, ma'am. Fantastic, it certainly is. Tempo means how fast the song is going. I want to invite you guys to help us with a song. And actually, it's probably more like harm us with a song. My student said, please don't let them do this. But I trust you guys. I think you're trustworthy people. So we have a piece we're gonna play next, and it has a particular tempo. Like the director told us, or the composer, play it at this speed. And that speed is 158, which, that doesn't sound that fast, right? Here's 158. 158 sounds like this, if I can get my phone to do it. That's 158. Our trombones play a funny little figure at the beginning, and they're gonna take it at 158. So 158 is here. One, two, one, two, three, four. Okay, so to me, that sounds a little on the slow side. I sometimes think tempos are suggestions, kind of like the speed limit. I'm kidding. The speed limit is not a suggestion. The speed limit is totally follow that to the letter of the law. But tempos are a slight suggestion. So I want you guys to help us make this piece cook a little bit more. Can one of you give me a tempo that we're going to try to use that's faster than one? Oh, I see hands already. Blue shirt, dark blue shirt. Yes, ma'am. Oh, okay. I told them be ready for 200, not 250. Let's see. What's your name, hon? Say Sophie? Sophie's the new Grayson. Okay. What's the S word for Sophie? Sophie the terrifying. I mean, that's not right. 250. Let's see. I don't think I can count that fast. You have another suggestion? He said 200. We're going to go in the middle of that. Let's do 230. 230. Don't hate me. They said it. Listen, I'm just going with the audience. Please, give me. Hush.
What the?
That still feels mean, okay. Let's try it. One, two, one, two, three, four. Okay, we're gonna do 200. That felt way too fast. But do you see what tempo can do for you? My goodness, it can change an entire piece. So keep that in mind next time you're playing a piece. Play with tempo a little bit. Maybe you take it faster, maybe take it slower. 200.
One, two, three, four.
Flat.
Thank you.
a feeling we barely held that one together. Some of you people are, whew, that was a little cruel. My last feature today, have you guys noticed some of this happen in every single song where there was one, I'm gonna give you a clue, one person was playing kind of only with our rhythm section. Did you guys notice that happening? Do you know what that's called? Starts with an S, it's a four-letter word. Starts with an S and it ends with an O. Shh. Who said it? Solo, yes, we had a couple of solos. One of the lovely aspects of jazz music is that it is filled with solos. A lot of times they'll encourage you not just to play a solo, but to make it up as you go along, which is called improvisation. And you're gonna see that in this next set we're gonna play. There's gonna be a solo, it's gonna be improvised, and I will not tell you what instrument is gonna play it. We'll see if you can figure out what instrument plays that solo. It's not gonna be an instrument you maybe expect. So keep that in mind. Here we go, guys. Our next set, our last piece for the set is going to be, you know, hopefully, yes. Was it? What instrument for the solo? Wow. 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 Okay, take a bow, Miss Tambourine. It wasn't Miss Tambourine exactly. It was somebody else. Anyone want to take a wild guess as to who it may have been? Don't you just. Okay, well, drums are always basically soloing, but no, not the drums. Hush your mouth. Fired. All of you, fired. Okay, so you're giving the answers. Yes, I heard someone say piano. It was our pianist who was soloing. It probably sounded a little like a tambourine too, because it's nice and high. So yeah, that was him. Give him a round of applause. All right, we're gonna transition from our jazz to our koinonia. And while we're doing that, I need to ask a couple of questions of someone in the audience. My students have been sitting here in fascination, looking at a young person in the audience who has the raddest haircut I have seen in a while. And it told me, you need to find out what this child's name is. He's not looking at me, so I feel like he doesn't know who I'm talking about. Mr. Here in the frontish row with the awesome haircut. Hello there. Hi. We would love to know what your name is, sir. Do you have a name? It's what? Eric. It fits. People, his name is Eric. Eric with the amazing haircut. Sir, we love your haircut. And we have just embarrassed poor Eric. Our apologies. Next time, we'll do better. As they're coming up, we're going to do a little changeover for them to close out. And we wanted to do a couple of things for you guys at the end of your chapel. One, we wanted to give you, there's a couple of messages in these songs that we're going to be singing for you today that hopefully you can take with you for the rest of your school year. How much time do you have left in school now? 4 weeks. Oh my goodness, you say it like 4 weeks. You understand how painful this is? I feel your pain. I'm a teacher. I have 4 weeks left with these kids too. So I'm right there with you. I'm ready for this to be over with. Kidding. We love them. Come on up, guys. Come on up. Take your time. Or not. So this group has an actually special name, and their name is Koinonia. It's like the word coin, and then you say Nia at the end of it, Koinonia, or coin, no, and then Nia, Koinonia. Does anyone want to take a wild guess as to what Koinonia might actually mean? And I'll give you a clue, it's Greek, even though it's probably not much of a clue. So does anyone want to take a guess as to what Koinonia could Mr. Green Shirt, you always have the answer. What is it, sir? Well, we hope that that's what it means for us today, but Koinonia actually means, well, it has a few different meanings, but it kind of means fellowship and sharing. And so they named themselves years ago. It predates, they were not even alive when Koinonia, the name, was originated, but they named this group as that because they're our sharing group. They will go out and they will share music as our select choir. So it kind of worked perfectly that they should share with you. So this first piece we're going to share with you doesn't, what do I need to say about it? Listen to the middle section. You're not going to hear a solo, but you're going to hear something else towards the middle. I'll try to cue you what it is. Here we go. They're literally asking me what our first song is, and I'm in shock. Teachers, I commiserate with you. It's a rough life out there. Now, I set tempo for my jazz ensemble because I always want them to play faster, and they never play fast enough for me. And I feel the same for this group. They're just like jazz. They never sing fast enough for me. So let's see if we do this one fast enough, or they're going to make me stop them and say, let's go faster.
Thank you.
Now, one of my favorite little songs when I was younger than I am now, but I want to say when I was a child because I'm still close to being childish in my behavior. But when I was younger, one of my favorite songs was I've Got Peace Like a River. How many people have sung that song at some point in time? Everybody. Okay, well, listen, as you get older, sometimes songs change. They do this thing called mature. Do you guys know what the word mature means? Nobody has any idea what mature means? That probably is telling. Yes, ma'am. Yes, they grow up and they start maybe behaving a little differently. Yes, sir. Woo! Talk about calling out. Listen, my group, they do the same thing to me. They call me out too. So I accept the burn on behalf of everyone else here. So this song from when you used to sing it, I've Got Peace Like a River, we're going to sing a little mature version of it. So as you guys mature, sometimes things will change for you, like the songs you sing. Here we go. I've Got Peace Like a River. And I feel like I'm out of time. Am I out of time? We wanted to do one last thing for you guys, because I recognize how many of my are graduating and heading to high school? Heading into high school? Okay, we wanted to give you guys one last message, and this is a work in progress song, I'll be clear. We're still working on this song. And I talk about tempo. I don't know if they're gonna sing the right tempo I'm looking for. There's another word I wanna talk about, dynamics. You know what dynamics means? No. Yes. Good grief, girl, listen. Honey, what's your name? Izzy, intelligent Izzy. Wow, I love it. Thank you, Izzy. Dynamics, yes. So dynamics means how loud or how soft we sing. So to you graduating, you're heading off to college. Not college, excuse me. I'm talking about them. You're headed to high school. Mercy, you're headed to high school. And we want to remind you, wherever you go, whatever school you go to, don't let anyone turn you around from what you know and believe, what you've learned here at this school. You've got some fantastic teachers. I met many of them at Music Festival and met some of them today. I know this is a great environment for you. I know these are great people here for you, and they're teaching you wonderful things. So as you go off into high school, wherever it is you're going to go, don't let anybody turn you around from what you know and you believe, what you've learned. And that's our last song for you today. Thank you for being such a fantastic audience. We would love to stay here all day, but we can't. I know you can't either. So to the teachers, to your principal, Mr. Reyes, thank you so very much.
You said that was in the work?
Yes, we're working on it.
Oh, really? I could not tell. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. And know that you are always welcome at Intermountain Adventist Academy. So we're going to pray and close this, and we'll be heading our different directions and do what we have to do for the day. Let's pray. Our Lord, please be with Campion, the Campion group today, as whatever activities they have for the day, please protect them, take them where they're going, the next station. And Lord, be with these young people. Lord, there's so much out there, so many distractions, that they may stay faithful to what they have been taught and what they know is the right thing. And bless the adults also, work for them and lead them in the right way. And help us here at our school too. We pray the things in Christ's name. Amen.